Welcome to the Cleveland Museum of Natural History's Wildlife Resource Center. I'm Harvey Webster. Today, for this edition of Creature Features, we've come out of our shell. We're talking turtles. Today, I'm joined by Nikki McClelland, Wildlife Specialist, and we're here in the Wildlife Resource Center with King Koopa. Hi, Nikki.
Hi.
Who is King Koopa?
King Koopa is our resident animal ambassador, common snapping turtle. He has been with us for about 2 years, and he actually has a very important lesson to teach people. Someone found him when he was probably just 4 or 5 days old. When he was first found, he was the size of a half dollar, so he had just hatched. He was a very new hatchling, and they thought that he was lost because he wasn't near water. He was trying to cross a road, so they picked him up and they took him home. And then after a few days, they realized that they didn't really know how to take care of him, so they gave him to one of our workers here at the museum who brought him here for our advice on how to care for him.
Good lesson to be learned there. You know, it's interesting because in springtime, so many people are apt to encounter young animals, and we always think, oh, they're orphaned and they need our help, when most of the time we're just interfering and making things worse. So we encourage folks, if you ever have a situation like that, call us here at the Natural History Museum or contact a local wildlife rehabilitation center and get accurate information on whether you should or should not get involved. So he's getting pretty big here. How big will he get?
This guy, the largest snapping turtle on record, has a carapace, which is their top shell, has a carapace of 20 inches, although average is about 14.
Looks like he's got some interesting webbing on the feet, so we presume that he lives in the water.
He does. He's one of our largest water turtles here. He likes to dig. He has some very large claws there, and these guys can actually be rather dangerous when they're a little bit older. They got the name snapping turtles because, unlike other turtles, they can't fully close up into their shell for protection, so instead they snap. And actually, once he gets a little older, that neck is extremely long and mobile. He could turn around and actually bite my fingers all the way back here.
The other thing that's really cool about him is that when you take a close look at that face, the face is really very exquisitely camouflaged. It's got lots of colors on it. Even though the eyes kind of stick out here, you can imagine if this turtle was down on the bottom of a pond or a lake with lots of sediment around him, he'd be pretty hard to pick out, and might be that a fish would go swimming right past him and become a tasty little morsel.
That is actually how they hunt. They have the ambush method. They will completely ambush their prey. So they are a pretty hefty predator. Very, very impressive. And they do blend in very well with their habitat. They actually don't like to come out of the water very often. So if you see them basking, you usually see just the top of their shell. And if you look at his head design, his nostrils are right at the tip of his snout. So he doesn't even have to bring his head all the way out of the water. He just sticks that snout up to get a breath so that he's nice and protected.
And then what are we feeding the king here at the museum?
He gets a steady diet of water turtle pellets, which are not his favorite. He does like his meat. He's a meat and potatoes kind of guy. So he gets some super worms. He really likes his fish. He'll get some mealworms, and he'll also get some crickets.
Excellent. So what do we do for enrichment for this turtle?
Well, out in the wild, this guy would be hunting, and a lot of his prey, it's pretty easy to catch because we have to know exactly how much it is that he's eating, so we keep very close track of it. So for enrichment here, we regularly change up his tank. He has quite the interesting personality where he is very interested in what's going on around him. So we've tried hanging some vegetables because even though he likes his meat, these guys would eat some plant matter out in the wild. So we've put in whole apples for him to attack. We've put in carrots for him to attack. And he'll amuse himself for hours trying to get a bite out of those things.
The king is one of those animals that we maintain in our Wildlife Resource Center. So if visitors come to the museum, they can't regularly see King Koopa, but there are times when they can. And when will those be?
We have a daily live animal shows Monday through Friday at 1:30. We kind of bill those as a creature feature, kind of like this. People come up with animals, and you never know who you're going to encounter. It could be a turtle, it could be a skunk, it could be a raptor. And we also do live animal shows at 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock on the weekends.
Fabulous. Nikki, thank you very much. We've been joined by Nikki McClelland, Wildlife Specialist at the Cleveland Museum of Natural History's Wildlife Resource Center, and King Koopa, our common snapping turtle.